Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back at long last to Pokemon Mystery Dungeon, Explorers of Sky. I deeply apologize for the very long break between episodes, but I'll have plenty of time to talk about that during the non-cutscenes of the game, aka the gameplay. But for now, we have some more cutscenes. If you forgot where we left off last time, because, you know, it's been 3 months or so, we just got back from the future. We went with Grovyle to go to Tree Shroud Forest, and he got the first time gear, and now we've split up. Grovyle's gonna get the rest of the time gears, and now Lorimei and Dinsai have to go back to the guild, because they're gonna try to find the hidden land, and we need help, so we're going back to the guild to ask them for help. Okay, here we are, Lorimei, Wigglytuff's guild. Feels as if we were gone a long time, but it was technically just one whole day. Now that we're here, it's kind of awkward to go in, for all we were suddenly taken away in front of everyone. It would sort of be strange to suddenly just show up. No, we can't be acting all bashful now. We just gotta show up. Tell them the truth. Okay, I'll stand up at the sentry post. Pokemon detected. Who's footprint? Footprint belongs to. Footprint belongs to. What's wrong, Diglett? Respond. What? Hey, Diglett. Where do you think you're burrowing off to?
That footprint. It's Dinsai.
What?
What?
What? It is Dinsai! And Lorimei too! Diglett, long time no see! It was one day, didn't they make clear it was one whole day the last time? Maybe he was wrong. Hey, it's true!
Oh my gosh, it really is Lorimei and Dinsai!
You're both alive! We worried so much about you.
I was bug golly! Everyone, we're home! We're finally home!
Yeah, we're home. Thanks for the welcome. Glad you guys are happy to see us.
Welcome home, Dinsai, Lorimei! Yay!
What? What was that again? Just hold on for a moment. Let me get this story straight. Okay. Let me summarize the story so far. Gotta make it first. Grovyle is actually the good guy. And he was collecting time gears to save the world. Yes. And the Great Dustin were only pretending to be kind and helpful, because he was actually a heinous and wicked villain.
Yeah. I didn't really phrase it heinous and wicked, but, you know, I'm not inaccurate.
And also, Lorimei was really Grovyle's partner?
Yes.
So Dustin wanted to get rid of both Lorimei and Grovyle? So it took them to the future?
Yeah, and me too, for some reason.
And you managed to escape from Dustin by the skin of your teeth. You barely made it to get back from the future.
Yes.
And finally, this planet will soon become paralyzed. And to prevent that, Grovyle has undergathered the time gears again. Meanwhile, you were swirling in flames. Well, you know what? I didn't need to summarize before we walked into this episode. Chatot's doing it. Yes, that's all the story. Dinsai, Lori, ha! You must have been a bad streamer or something, huh? Why didn't you just hold me to get some rest?
Then wait a second now! You think we're lying? We just went through the stupid thing in the future. We're ghosts, attackers in the walls. I'm sure it's true.
We had a monster house in the Tree Shop Forest. I'll talk about that too.
A good nap will fix your worries. That's not it, Chatot. Seriously, come on. The world's gonna blow up. That's quite enough. Not blow up, but be terrible. Is there any part of your story that's even remotely plausible? A place called the Hidden Land? That's a really poor name for a land. If it's called the Hidden Land, if we ever find it, what is it going to be if it changes name to the Found Land? That doesn't make any sense. And Dustor's a great guy. How dare you accuse him of such things?
Well, I didn't believe it either, but, like,
he grabbed us and put us in the future. I'll hear no more of this. I don't care what you say. The Great Dustor, the villain? That's simply unbelievable. Seriously, don't you two feel the same way? How can anyone see the Great Dustor as a villain? We hold Dustor in high esteem. We cannot believe it. See? Everyone shares the same opinion. Everyone shares the same opinion. I'm looking at all of you. You share the same opinion, right?
But...
Did I hear some... What's the word? Questioning of the opinion of the group?
There's something I don't understand, though. He was returning to the future... And we were all, like, kind of watching this happen, and he clearly grabbed them and brought them in the hole.
Does anyone just forget about that?
He clearly did that. He was super obvious that he grabbed them. He grabbed us, and, yeah. So, what, yeah. It doesn't make any sense. That's a chat, Todd. Really? Don't you think they just fell in by accident? Okay, how do you... No, Chad, you're just being dumb now. No way! He grabbed and yanked him in! I saw it!
Hey, that's right. It looked that way to me, too. Hey, what happened was really weird.
But gosh, I really had to wonder why Dr. Nora did something like that.
If this descent is true, then what this door did suddenly makes perfect sense.
What? Run a minute! So what are you saying now? You're actually saying that you now believe Denzel Lorimer are claiming? How dare you not agree with my opinion? You're all banished!
I believe them.
What did you say? Is that you're banished?
Oh my golly, I surely did think highly of the great Dusk Noir. The whole idea sounds troubling when you put it that way. Something more important here. Yup, Lorimer and Denzel are more important. That's why I believe Lorimer and Denzel have to say.
What? Beedoo, thanks!
Hey, I believe too.
Me too, oh my gosh, they're our guild colleagues after all.
Oh, Corfish and Sunflora.
I believe them!
Me too!
So do I. Casting doubt on our colleagues is wrong. Their trust is a must. Tusker, you just said there's no way you'll believe them, but okay. Gah!
Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Thank you for believing us. And not just agreeing with Chatot because he threatened to banish you.
Sounds like we all agree! Except Chatot. He can be banished.
So to the Hidden Land! Well, hold on, the Guildmaster.
What's wrong?
We're not all in agreement yet, are we? We're all good with the story, except Chatot.
Oh, that's all. Don't worry about Chatot. He's banished.
Right? You're convinced, right,
Chatot?
Wait, what is he saying?
Well, goodness, there's no fooling you. I admit it. I believe you guys from the start. I was just testing you all. It was all a test. Good job. You all passed.
What's really? Really, Chatot?
That's why I was the contra. I wanted to put your friendship to the test. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a likely story.
I was convinced at the get-go. Yep, I knew everyone would surely believe their own colleagues.
Uh-huh. Yeah, sure.
Yeah, totally, but it's true.
Lorimer, Denzel, I believe you. You're my friend in the guild membership. Now listen, everyone. Time is stopping in more and more places. From Denzel's story, we know our world is in danger. That means we have to do something. This is our time. In the name of Wigglytuff's guild, we'll combine all of our efforts. We'll discover the Hidden Land. Let's do this, everyone. Hooray!
Chatot?
Yes, sir.
Okay, everyone. From now on, we're shifting all efforts located in the Hidden Land.
We'll let everyone know what is happening in our world. It's going to get busy. We'll all have to work hard.
I sure will.
I'll put down the treasure town. I'll get the world out, by golly.
I'll go, too.
Well, let Azelf and his friends know, too. To back up the lakes, they made a try to stop Grovyle.
Hey, I'll go tell them.
Yeah, Corfish will just run along and tell them real quick before Grovyle gets to them, even though he's already on their way.
Yes, sir. We'll hurry.
We'll find the Hidden Land together. Yoom-ta!
Hooray! Let's show some guts. Hey.
I'm sorry I didn't have any information about the Hidden Land, but maybe the wise Torkoal, the town endler.
Oh, yay, this pointless level. This is a great level to actually talk about stuff and not pay attention to anything that's going on. So, we remember.
Yeah, the hot spring, you know? That's just the place on the map that we can just go there. But they're gonna make us go to the waterfall cave again.
You know that really old dungeon we did near the beginning of the game? I don't understand that. The hot spring is not part of the waterfall cave. It's a different area. They established that when we went to the waterfall cave and we pushed the gem, it flooded us out and we ended up way outside the cave into a different area, into the hot spring. It's not part of the cave, but, oh, we gotta eat first. And then go back to sleep. Didn't we just wake up? Like, we just woke up, went to Treasure Town,
never mind. Today was Tree Shroud Forest Day. Okay. I'm getting days mixed up. Because it was a long time ago between recording. Okay.
But yeah, this is the most pointless level of the whole game. They make you do Waterfall Cave again.
Whatever. We have to do it, so it'll be a great time to talk about stuff.
Is this more cutscene? I think it's more cutscene.
It's been so long since we've been in this room, it feels as though I'm finally home. You know, I'm glad everyone came to believe our story.
It made me a little choked up.
Let's go meet Torkoal tomorrow and talk with him. Let's get back at it tomorrow, Lorimer.
Oh yeah.
The next morning, Up and Adam, it's morning!
Oh yeah, we wake up from him now. Oh yeah, great. Yeah, we will now save our game after all we did today so far was about 10 minutes of cutscene. All right, let's get out. Oh my god, I realize we have a ton of items I gotta organize. Oh boy, I have like several dungeons worth of items. Yes, we just read already what we're all gonna do. So there's no way to reread that. Shout out. We must go to the hot spring, yes. We do not need to go to the waterfall spring to get the hot spring, that is a lie. But where they make us do it anyway. So let's just go, I guess. And I guess I do have to do item organization, don't I? Oh boy. Okay. This is gonna take me a little while, but to you guys, it'll take like half a second because I'm gonna skip it all. But all right, I'm gonna do item organization and purchasing. I'll let you all know when I'm done. All right, we're sort of done. I got a ton of boxes. I'm gonna open all of them just to see if anything in it is remotely good. In this box, there is a brown gummy. Okay, that's fine. Glittery box. Quee quee qua! Qua ha! It is Gabite Claw. Okay. Those are actually pretty rare items. They're very specific items for very specific Pokemon, but only if I'm using a Gabite. I'm not using a Gabite, so. Tort Claw. Okay. Another single, you know, one Pokemon only typed item. And this is a Vile Seed. Those would be good if I was allowed to throw items at enemies, but I'm not, so it's not helpful. This is a Black Gummy. Okay, that's good. That is definitely good. Gummies are good in general, so that's never a bad thing. This box is an Insomniscope. I forget what that is. Is that a like a anti-sleep held item? Junior Beam. I'm not sure what that is. I'll go look at it. And Quaha, this one is a flamethrower. Oh, just a flamethrower. An actual flamethrower in a box. Wow, it's a pretty rare item. And this one is a Magmar Claw. Okay. Wait, is it Magmore Claw? Maybe it's Magmortar, not Magmar. I don't know. And this one is a Gibble card. Okay. Well, that was all of them, right? Yeah. Okay. So let's. What are all these items? Goodbye Claw. Goodbye specific item. Slightly boosts attack. Gives it to all these members. Goodbye Gibble, goodbye and Garchomp. Okay. Torkoal is Torterra. Vile Speed. Yeah, I'm not allowed to use that. Black Gummy's fine. Prevent sleep. Is that all it does? Yeah. Yep, prevent sleep. Mime Junior specific item. Okay, never would have guessed that. Flamethrower. Okay. Those are all fairly good. Not really a huge fan of the character specific items, but I'm gonna keep them anyway. Because I feel weird selling rare items. So I'm gonna just store all those. I'm gonna store Flamethrower too. And I'll also store the Vile Seed, because why not? I'm gonna turn the gummies into juice. And I'm gonna sell the Insomniscope. So yeah, that's all. I'll see you when I'm ready for the dungeon. All right, here we go, Waterfall Cave. Let's do it. You're gonna be so friggin' easy waste of time dungeon. So let's talk about stuff. The first obvious question I'm going to answer is, well, why the heck has it been 3 months since the last episode? And in all honesty, I've taken on too much stuff to do at the same time. And it was just too much to do, and unfortunately, that's completely my fault. I should not have taken on all these things at once to do, but that's what I decided to do. So, there had to be one thing of these things that I decided to do all at the same time that had to suffer, and unfortunately, it was this series. That wasn't necessarily by choice, it was just because this was, of all the things that I was doing, this was the least convenient. If that makes any sense at all. basically, the things that I have been doing, well, first of all, full-time job, and a kid. Oh yeah, and Dinsai has Water Pulse now, so he can now shoot things with distance. It's pretty freaking great. It's awesome. Glad you witnessed it right there. What are his item? What are his moves, by the way, right now? Just water. He can use all his moves for now. Been working on Sunrise a lot. Oh yeah, full-time job and kid and stuff. And actually, I haven't mentioned this in any episodes yet, but mentioned on live stream a couple times. I actually have a second kid on the way. He'll be born in about a month. I'll have two now. So my time is not gonna get. The amount of time I have to do this stuff is not gonna go up. That's for sure. It is absolutely just going to go down, which is unfortunate, but that's the way it goes. Also live streams. I've been doing live streams, 3 nights a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and I really, really enjoy them. If I'm being 100% honest, I feel like I actually enjoy doing live streams more than these playthroughs where it's not live. Like, you know, I'm recording it, then I edit it, then I upload it to YouTube, and you guys watch it. It's post-viewing, as opposed to live streams where it's live. People watch it as I do it, and I constant interaction with people as we're watching. I realize I like that format a bit more. And by that, I still do enjoy this, because if I really didn't enjoy this, I just simply wouldn't do it. I would say, screw this series. I don't feel like finishing it. But, no, I do still enjoy this, just not quite as much. We're already full on items. I guess I shouldn't have jam-packed myself with items for this really pointless dungeon, but at the same time, I don't really care. I'll get rid of an apple. Actually, I'll eat the apple. I'll eat it off the ground. Hold on, eat it. I know I'm not gonna run out of hunger, but I just... couldn't like a good apple go to waste? There are Pokemon starving all over the world in the third world Pokemon countries. and I can't pick up the Ornberry, that's fine. I don't care. So yeah, oh, and Sunrise, did I mention that? Yeah, I mentioned it briefly. I've been working a lot on that. So that's a lot more convenient for me to work on than this, because, you know, I could work at any time without limits. It's just working on my computer. I don't have to, like, go down to my basement after my son is asleep and then do a recording where, you know, no one's actively watching me like in a live stream where they would be. It's something I have to actually go out of my way to do. And usually it's like, you know, I don't really feel like recording that right now. I feel like I'm making good progress with the series. I gotta make progress in the series, stuff like that. So, there you go. There you have it. That's basically it. I've been doing way too many things at one time, and unfortunately, this is the series that had to suffer. Or this is the thing that I've been doing that suffered because of the too many things at once. And unfortunately, I don't think it's gonna improve. But that being said, this series should be finished soon. That brings me to my next point that I want to talk about before I forget to talk about it. I have mentioned many times throughout this playthrough that I planned to do the post-game. However, as last episode, for those that maybe not remember because it was 3 months ago, if that episode is any evidence, I'm not going to have fun with it. And it's very clear, based on the response of last episode and basically the entirety of, the Ultra Sun Nuzlocke, you guys don't really like it when I don't enjoy the game I'm playing. It's funny, right? Maybe when I say that, you might think that's super obvious, and you know, in my opinion, it sounds like it makes sense. I just know lots of YouTubers, or I know of a lots of YouTubers, that feel like them, like, criticizing and complaining about a game is, like, an appeal to them. And that's fine if it's not for me. I can completely understand. I just rewatched that episode before I went into this recording just to make sure I knew exactly where I was and everything. And I can completely understand. It's probably not a great idea to be constantly frustrated and constantly pointing out the things I don't like about a game. That's just how I am, though. When I play a game and that's something that's happening in the game, it's something I want to talk about. It's a conversation topic. That's something I also strive to do while I play through games. See, now we're just mad at the hot spring. That's not how it works. It's not at the end of the cave. We push the crystal. Okay, forget it. Cutscene, then I'll go back to talking. Oh, my young friends, come to wash away your exhaustion. Oh, not so. I see. You seek my wisdom. There's no better place to share your story. Yeah, we're skipping. Oh, I see. The hidden land, you say. I have heard of it. Oh, really? Hidden Land is truly a place of legend. It's tattered lore at best, handed down by oral tradition. Well, I mean, Pokemon doesn't really have books. So, it had to be passed out orally. Of course, I can tell you only what I've heard. Hidden Land lies beyond the sea. A hidden place, No, you don't say. Hidden place, yes. The hidden land allows only the chosen to find it. Plot convenience can only choose it. You must possess certain qualities. You have the qualifications. Okay, what are the qualifications? Well, since no one has ever found it, I guess I don't know what they are. Slipped my mind. Oh, you've forgotten! Please remember! Please! It's really important! That's easy for you to say, but... Oh, now I remember! You need proof! Proof of some sort. That was a proof. Proof? What kind of proof? Proof that you are a good person and not trying to destroy the temporal tower? I don't know. Sorry to disappoint you. Alright, can you go anything else at all? No, that's all. For me, youngsters, recall what proof you need. I'll be sure to let you know. Thank you, Targol.
Go back to the guild, Lorimer.
So Targol couldn't provide us with any answers. That's too bad. Well, that's not entirely true. We know that we need proof. Knowing this is a step forward, right? Hey, we're searching too. Yeah, we didn't find anything. But there's no giving up. We have to keep trying, by golly. We gotta keep trying too. Dinner and rest over the night. Resume our efforts tomorrow. All right, well, thanks, everyone. Yeah, nom, 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 nom. So, yeah, post-game is just more of what I was frustrated about in the last episode. Monster houses, traps, they just multiply. So, even though I played it in my special way that I was talking about, I still don't think I would enjoy it. And, like I said, if it's any evidence, you guys won't enjoy it. If you don't, you guys won't enjoy me being frustrated, so I won't enjoy it, so I think I'm just not gonna do it. That's the way it is. So I'm gonna talk less, we had a hope. What are Grovyle is doing? Is he gathering time gears? He can't gather all of them in one day. We just went through a very easy dungeon and it took us the whole day. So, yeah. I hope there's another dungeon I can keep talking about, because there's really more I want to talk about the last episode. Some points about that episode that I liked. I just feel like if I start talking now, it'll be interrupted by a cutscene where there's other characters talking. So, I'll wait. Ahem, so in short, the Hidden Land remains a shrouded in mystery. It's still the Hidden Land, not the Found Land. Hooray! Let's go investigate. Investigation. Where should we go investigate today? We're talking to Torkoal. We're out of ideas. Appointment detected! Whose footprint? Footprint belongs to Torkoal, the town handler! What? Torkoal is here? Oh, finally I caught up with you. I've been walking back to the guilds since you left me yesterday. That's how long it took me to get here. I'm really freaking slow. Hey, I bet I remembered. I remember what I was trying to say. I contemplated the water of the hot spring, and one recollection surfaced. But it really is something very, very small. I worry it would be worthwhile sharing. Not a worry! Every little bit of information helps, however small. Please say it! Well, I did climb all the way up this freaking mountain, so... You need a qualification to go there. Or a little bit more about that proof. The proof? There is an inscription of a certain pattern. A certain pattern? Hey Hayes, what kind of pattern would that be? Or how can I describe it? It's difficult to describe it. Like inside the pattern is quite intricate and odd. It's a peculiar pattern, the kind of pattern you rarely see. Golly! You think I could get something? Try to think of such a thing, it's not easy when one tries. What could that be? The kind of pattern you rarely see. What could a pattern like that look like? A pattern you rarely see. Peculiar. Wait a minute! It's a peculiar pattern! I remember that time! Remember that thing that Densai carries all the time? He's had it at the very beginning, the relic fragment. It looks like junk, but it has this peculiar pattern. I feel like pattern's not an amazing word for this description, because like a pattern can mean like anything. Pattern has like a million definitions, but I don't know. Maybe like symbol, insignia, inscription, something like that. I feel like words like that would make more sense for this, but at this point I'm nitpicking a Japanese translated game. This pattern right here! This pattern! This stone I just happen to have! This is it! It is literally this, right in front of me! Where did you get this? I'm not sure if I can remember. I just happened to find it. Yippee, this is fabulous! Densai has this! Does that mean Densai is qualified to go to the Hidden Land? Just him? Well, I don't know. Maybe. You have to have that. Yeah, that's right. But I don't know if that means you are the chosen one. That just might be the key. But, like, you know, you have to actually physically open the door. I don't know if you're the chosen one to actually open the door, you know? There's no question this pattern is something you do with the Hidden Land. Knowing that is a lot. I suppose. Wait, you do realize the Hidden Land is only speaking Logan legend, right? You're not actually trying to find it, right? This is all just hypothetical. Yes, we are, Torkoal, really. My goodness, I had no idea. I thought you guys just liked legends or something. This pattern, we've seen this somewhere, haven't we? What? Yes, the sea inlet to the northwest. Brine Cave. It was named after a Pokemon attack. Yes, I know, the vicious bandit was there. A vicious bandit? By golly! Everyone, please listen. I once saw this pattern deep inside a place called Brine Cave. I think we discover more by taking the relic fragment there. However, there is one problem. A Pokemon lurks there who is a vicious bandit. Hey, hey, we're not letting that scare us! Aren't we your explorers? We arrest bandits for a living! Well, not just bandits. We also do really random chores. For people like, I lost my Orenberry in this one cave on this specific floor. You know, that, and we catch outlaws, so. Oh, I think that Hidden Lore is telling nothing but then folklore. Getting this old made my thinking so inflexible. That's very sad. All this makes me remember the days when I dreamt of romance and adventure. Help me seek my dreams again. Do your best. Ho, ho, ho. Now I'll take my walk all back to the hot spring. Oh my god, by this one, it'll be like the middle of the day. All right. All right, everyone. Spend the rest of the day getting ready. Okay, dismissed. All right, when has he ever said dismissed? Okay. Yup, yup, we'll get ready, by golly. Oh my gosh, we're so exciting. So, Brine Cave. All right, we are nearing the end of this game. Chata, you save the guild tomorrow on standby.
Guildmaster, forgive me if I'm out of line, but screw you, I'm going to Brine Cave.
No, I can't let you face danger like that ever again.
But that's why I have to go.
Please, send me to Brine Cave. Come on. Okay, I want you to go with Team Sunrise. Go with them, not me.
Be careful, though.
Thank you. I will not let you down. I have something I need to do, so I'll have to go out. You're in charge while I'm gone.
As you wish.
Great, we got a babysit Chatot. He's not very good.
So this is where it stands. You two will be with me tomorrow. As such, Team Sunrise non-guild members may not come along. That's okay. We never use them anyway. Brave is a vicious foe lying in wait. You mustn't let down your guard. Don't do anything that keeps me from succeeding there.
Keeps you from succeeding there. Yeah, that's how it'll work, Chatot. Go to Treasure Town? Well, wait, so what are we doing today?
Oh, it's already been an hour and I'm only here!
I'm kidding.
Well, ho, ho! Hold there, old timer!
Oh, yeah. Did you forget these guys were characters? Yeah, I mean, me too.
What do you guys want? Chaw! Well, we're Team Skull! Hey, did you have a little bit of guild? Well, ho, ho, I ever heard you say something that sounded fun.
Some other Hidden Land, chaw!
I think I forgot what voices I did for these guys. Oh well.
I was only...
Huh? Someone's coming! Whoa ho ho, guild chumps!
Old timer, why don't we take this chat somewhere we won't disturb? Cha ha ha! Hey! I can't move very fast! Stop it!
So, like, what do our characters do today? Is it just a random mission day? And then tomorrow we do the Brine Cave? Or... I guess, let me try to leave. I'll exit. But get ready for tomorrow's mission. We should go off on an adventure. Let's go to Church Town. Oh. Is there a cutscene waiting for us or something? I legitimately don't remember. No, we just set up. And then by tomorrow, they mean... Okay, whatever. I'll get items ready. I'll let you know when I'm done. Hey, so I found the move Facade. Let's see. Its hit ratio is 5 stars. Its power is 6 stars. What's Tackle? Tackle is... Oh, so Facade has a low accuracy? Stars are win-win, you know, whatever. 4-star power, but it is +1. What is Quick Attack? 3 stars. Okay. I'm really considering keeping it. Helping Hand is really helpful, though. And Bite helps us hit ghosts. I bought it from the Kecleons. This is actually tricky because it's a really good high base power normal move, and I'll get stabbed from it. It's just, you know what? I think I'm gonna get rid of Bite. Yep, get rid of Bite. Cool, okay. That's it. I'm not done yet.
Okay, we got 3 boxes to open.
3 boxes. The dainty box first. Quick, quick, whoa! Is revealed a squirt foam. Ew. Alright, it's Squirtle item, basically. So if we were Squirtle, that would be good. A Pikachu card. Another starter item. Okay? So if we were a team of Pikachu and Squirtle, we'd have our personal cards now. And this is a Bulbaclaw. Okay, or if we were a Bulbasaur. Cool. Fun fact, I've been all those Pokemon before. Alright, I'll only store those and I'll meet you over where we're supposed to go. Alright, Lorimé. We should go over to Sharpedo Bluff before we go back to the Beagle, just in case Grovyle has come back. Ah, so we're waiting for that. That was why we couldn't go to the next level yet. We had to do a cutscene at Sharpedo Bluff. Okay, cool. Also, guys, I have absolutely no idea how long this episode is. So apologize if it's too long or too short. Grovyle back, I wonder? Let's go. Yeah, maybe we should put, like, a door on our house or something. There's nothing here to steal. It's just our beds, so whatever. Grovyle isn't here. Oh, over there, but he left a note. There is a sheet of paper. Oh, maybe they do have writing and books in this world. I don't know, they've never seen them before. There must be a message for us. Dinsai, we're reading the letter from Grovyle. To Lorimé and Dinsai, how are you doing? How goes your search for the hidden land? These are going well on my end. I've already collected 3 time gears. To find only 2 more time gears. Plan to join you and I've collected all 5. Plans have proceeded smoothly. Azelf and his friends understood the situation and they have fully cooperated. Azelf told me that members of your guild let them know I was coming. Thank you. It's heartening to know that more and more Pokemon are coming to trust us. However, I will continue to stay away from Treasure Town and the guild. First, I'm not certain the Pokemon of this world truly trust me or not. There's something more troubling than that. Dust Noir is liable to return from the future anytime. Dust Noir! Come to think of it, he failed to get rid of us in the future. I wouldn't put it past him to chase us here. He still wants us gone. Okay, I'll keep reading. Since Dust Noir will be coming, we should keep a low profile. This is another reason I should stay away from the Treasure Town and the Guild. I may instead come back to Sharpedo Bluff or the beach. If we should meet, we can then exchange information. Good luck on your end. Together we shall stop the planet's paralysis. From Grovyle. Okay, it sounds like Grovyle is hard at work. We better not fail on our end. According to this letter, Grovyle will show up either here or at the beach. Well, maybe we should go check the beach. And isn't it the beach where we have some sort of epiphany? I don't remember, actually. Like, I actually legitimately forgot what exactly happened at this point in the game. But it can't be too bad, right? Let's save the game just in case something happens. Because I'm not actually sure what's going to happen, so... Alright, to the beach! A Krabby? Ahoy! Mateys, are you going to the beach? Arr! Came out for something if you could recently. Bottles washing by the beach. Looks like there's something inside the bottles. Interesting about the bottles of the beach. Okay, I don't remember that cutscene at all. Is that a Sky exclusive one? We can look for a bottle when we go to the beach. Oh yes, this one. Chapter 18, that was one chapter, guys. All we did in that chapter was Waterfall Cave. Wow. That was a difficult chapter, guys. Hoping to see Grovyle here. No, he's not here after all. Speaking of not being here, the Krabby aren't here either. We just saw him leave. Tell us about bottles. I love seeing the bubbles go up in the sky. Yeah, well, that's too bad. It's a letdown, but oh well. But look, a sunrise! Oh, sunset. Sunset? Didn't we just wake up? I'm getting so confused. I swear our characters just woke up. But now it's sunset. Okay. So we're coughing and a sidekick. Coughing and his sidekick. Really? Coughing and his sidekick. Okay, that's what we're gonna call them now. I don't know how to respond to that. Okay. I was too scared to get it back. You gave me the courage then, Lorimé, you know? That was how we really started as a team. Getting back this relic fragment was Sunrise's first adventure. And now, we're using the same relic fragment as we go to the Hidden Land. Think about it, it's kind of strange. It's almost like plot convenient. My adventures with Dinsai and sort of the Hidden Land, the relic fragment started both. This beautiful sunset. Sunset, we have to stop. We can't miss any more sunsets. They're so cool. We have to do good tomorrow. Yeah, they're skipping a day just for the sake of plot, clearly. Because we did nothing this day. We woke up, Torkoal came to visit, and we, yeah. Wait, what is that? It's Lapras! That's not a spoiler. Anyone who knows what any Pokemon are, it's only the name of the chapter. So. Hello? Hi, Lapras. Hi. What could it be? It looks like it's swimming across the sunset. I don't think it's a Pokemon. You don't think it's a Pokemon? Or did he say he think it's a Pokemon? I read it too fast. The sun's almost gone. It's actually not different at all. But that's fine. We can pretend it looked different. Oh my god. Hey guys, remember, they're still characters. I'm not even going to read what they have to say. Because I've had enough with them. Yep, yep, I'm totally acknowledging you guys. Yep. Okay. Like, they have no impact on the story anymore, but they're still in the game for some reason. Yeah, that was a really, really short day. It's the moon. Yeah, I think I should end the episode before we go into Brine Cave, because I feel like this episode has been a lot of cutscene. And I've been recording for quite a while, but I've also cut out quite a lot, so yeah. Ooh, what do you know? Lapras knows Wigglytuff. Lapras! Long time no see. It's been too long, Wigglytuff. You look well. Is Chata doing well, too? Yes, very well. I'm glad to hear that. I've always meant to thank you. I deeply praise you the promise you made and upheld for all this time. No problem, no big deal. But today, I'm here to see you about that promise. We found ourselves in a situation where we can't afford to uphold that promise. I suspect that you know why. So please tell me about that strange pattern we once saw. The next morning. Banana, it's morning! So, what were they talking about? Ooh, it's a big mystery. We will solve that mystery as well as the mystery of the hidden land in the next episode. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I will see you all next time. And I also didn't even explain more. I didn't even finish explaining stuff. Wow. Okay, yeah. We'll do that next episode. See you then. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. And as always, rock on.